back nine here at Papago. Already played the front nine forward tees, so may as well play the back nine forward tees. 421 yard par five. I got this giant tree that I have to kind of avoid. So I'm gonna take it out to the right of it. Hopefully I can avoid the desert. Or I just may launch it straight over it. Left me 118 yards. Kind of shoved it out to the right, and I think it's a little short, but we got a chance at eagle. And before we get all into this round, as you guys always know, go pound that like button right there. Go subscribe. Really helps me out. Leave a comment and tell me what you guys think of this video. So I have about 21 feet or so. I don't have a coin. I'm just gonna go ahead and putt it. Chose to use a sand wedge, and I made sure I played it out right. I have about an 18 footer, a little right to lefter. Bingo. Yards right here. Got bunkers protecting this hole. I got to kind of thread the needle on this one, and I can't really hit this too hard either because I'll go over the green. A little sweet putt back there. Oh, that's gonna be in the bunker. slider from right to left. Got about 10 feet. I do have to be careful because it says downhill when it gets to the hole. And if I hit it a little too hard, I could have a big putt coming back. Directly over that dead tree right there. Fairway's actually out to the right, but I think I got enough carry to take it directly at the green. It may leave myself for an awkward little pitch, but closer to the green, the better. Challenge. It not only practices my accuracy off the tee, but it also really, really challenges my short game. About 20, 25 footer right here, going back uphill, and it's gonna slide hard to its left. Enough. Cups aren't big enough. Oh. 15 yards to the center of the green right there. Got a front flag. And we landed on the front of the green right there. Here, I'll show you. Check out this divot. This is what it looks like. This is what it looks like when you hit the green with the driver. Always, always fix your ball marks, people. I really wanted that putt. That would have been a great eagle. But I got another opportunity right here. Par 5, straight into the darkness, as you guys can see right there. 483 yards, so it does have a little bit of tee to it. Still have to hit some quality shots. I seem to have found the only wet spot here on this golf course. My ball landed right here, and it ended up right there. Should be up there. So now I have 200 yards into this par 5, so really now it's just like a regular par 5. Pole in the distance is the target. Oh no. That thing went that way. I wanted it to go that way. Classic mudder right there. You want to be. Now I have about a 50-yard bunker shot over another bunker to a short-sided pin. If I give myself a birdie opportunity, I succeeded. About a 15 footer, should slide to the right just a little bit. It's pretty flat, maybe uphill just a little bit. Get all this mud off. Aye. There's a little hump right here that prevented that ball from going that way. Good stroke, misread. Ah. Recording a 5 on the scorecard is just no fun. Any tee box that you play from, recording a 5 or higher, Number 16 is 338 yards. Directly over those bunkers, there's a lot of room out to the right. So if I'm gonna miss, I'm gonna make sure it's out to the right. Whew. Driver is hot. Woo! Not the best chips. Tried to use a little 8-iron bump and run, didn't work out. Guess you don't have to chip it close. Oh, putting. The greatest equalizer there is in this game. You don't have to chip the ball necessarily close in order to have low scores. You do have to putt well though. Par 3, a little different from up here. It's only 130 yards to this front pin. Got a little bit of headwind and I do have a bunker that's right in front of it, so I do have to make sure I get it all the way there. I'm gonna go ahead and blast a pitching wedge. Chunky monkey, but it got there. She's on fire. She's on fire right now. Number 18. Number 18 is straight over these trees. Now, I can either cut this ball or I can just take it straight at the pin with a high launch. I'm gonna launch it. Well, a little blue heeler, but I don't think it's gonna hurt me. Right there and kind of bumped and runned it. Not too bad. I'll take it. Now I do kind of have a little bit of a challenging putt right here because this putt wants to break this way, but it also wants to break this way because of the grain. I kind of have to play it on the left edge and I have to hit it kind of firm. like that.